Thank you. Deputy Harrigan.
Thank you, Kian Corla. Taoiseach, the results of a number of surveys released in recent weeks strongly indicate that the Irish consumer is still paying a premium for their groceries when compared to EU countries. While supermarket chains across the country have refused to disclose their figures regarding their profit margins. It's well known here in Ireland that Tesco are rumoured to dub this country Treasure Island. Despite families struggling to cope with the downturn, major supermarkets are pushing prices even higher than the boom time rates. A recent survey by the National Consumers Association found that 16 of the 19 grocery, popular and essential items had increased from between 12% and 32%. This was in spite of the fact, this is in 2011, in spite of the fact that the inflation rate is only 1.7%. Almost all of the products cost more than in the height of the boom, costing the average family an extra €870 a year. Taoiseach, there are also strong indications of widespread price matching amongst these chains. The profits they're extracting from the country are colossal. And isn't it time to give something back? Combat Poverty, when they were in existence, Social Justice Ireland and the St. Vincent de Paul have used definitions like profound when they talk about food deprivation and food poverty. And many of these groups, the supermarket chains, have no compassion whatsoever when they hear of people that are suffering food deprivation. As a matter of fact, they have no compunction in increasing their profits. My question to you, Taoiseach, and very briefly, I just want to tell you a very quick little instance. I was in a house last week with a mother and four children. The mother was ill. The eldest daughter was 14 years of age, and she was making dinner. And I was saddened and I was upset. The dinner consisted of beans and chips. That's wrong. And this was on a Sunday. Worse again, this was their Sunday meal, because they're struggling to make food last until they get paid maybe Tuesday or Wednesday from social welfare. That's unacceptable, and that is wrong when you see the profits that these supermarket chains are making.
Thank you.
My question to your Taoiseach is, would you invest the possibility of holding talks with the major retail chains to introduce a price freeze on household staples until the country's economy has turned around? Deputy Rabbit was able to do it in the 90s, if you can recall, Deputy, on a price freeze on drink. Surely we have it within our capability to at least bring in many of those chains and ask them to consider doing this. And finally, can I say, following talks with governments, major supermarket chains in a number of EU countries have introduced price freezes. Now, I think that we should bring in those chains and ask them to do it. If not, we ourselves should introduce price freezes on essential goods.
Thank you.
Bread, milk, butter and baby food.
Thank you, Cal Corla. I'm aware, first of all, that the Consumers Association of Ireland compared 19 branded products in 2011 and 2013, and they found that there was a 12.6% increase in the cost of the basket surveyed. However, that survey was, as I said, was confined to 19 branded products. The Central Statistics Office Consumer Price Index surveys over 50,000 prices taken on 632 item headings, and that shows that food and non-alcoholic beverage prices have fallen by 6.3% since 2008. However, the most recent CSO figures does show an increase of 1.6% for the year ending March 2013. And I understand that the explanation for that increase is that there has been an increase in certain commodity prices, some of which were affected by weather and energy costs. Now, the programme for government contains a specific commitment to enact legislation to regulate certain restrictive anti-competitive practices in the grocery goods sector. The government intends to give effect to this commitment by including an enabling provision in the Consumer and Competition Bill. This bill will also merge the National Consumer Agency and the Competition Authority, update and reform competition law on foot of a review of the operation and implementation of the Companies Act 2002, and give effect to the recommendations of the advisory group on mergers. Work on the drafting of the Consumer and Competition Bill is advancing, and the bill is included in the A list of the government's current legislative programme, so it's expected to be published this session. In addition to that, the staffing for enforcement in competition is being strengthened with the recruitment of some new personnel.
Thank you. Deputy Halligan.
I have no doubt in my mind that we're in the grips of a nutritional recession triggered by food poverty. And again, I would appeal to you that when you have those big supermarket chains who refuse to reveal their profits, and everybody knows the huge profits that they're making, where everybody else in this country have been asked to help out this economy, the people that are suffering food deprivation themselves have had to take cuts. Yet the big supermarket chains increase their profits year after year after year. Surely it's not an unreasonable request to ask you to do as other governments have done in other countries, that while this recession is still biting and taking hold and destroying people's quality of life, that at the very least, that they would put a hold and a freeze on essential food items. I'm asking you again, Tánaiste, you didn't answer that part of the question, and I recognise some of the answers you gave regarding your plans, but I'm asking you again, would you consider bringing in the Tescos, the Aldis, the Lidls, and ask them on the 19 most essential food items, which we all know, bread, milk, butter, baby food and so on, would they put a freeze on them just for 2 years? They're still going to make astronomical profits. It's there, we should be asking them to make their contribution to help out this economy where everybody else has made it. And I do believe that if they don't do it, we have the ability here as legislators to bring in a price freeze on essential items, and that we should do.
Thank you.
Well, as I've said, the route that the government is taking on this issue is the legislative route. We can ask, you can have all the discussions that you want, and yes, I would agree with you that supermarkets should not be increasing the prices of essential goods. But we intend to, we gave a commitment in the programme for government that we were going to deal with anti-competitive practices in the grocery goods sector. We are going to deliver on that. We are going to deliver on that in the Consumer and Competition Bill. That bill will be published this session. There will be an opportunity for members of the House, obviously, to participate in the debate on that bill when it is presented. And that action is being taken in order to protect the consumer, in order to protect consumers against overpricing, against profiteering, against anti-competitive practices in the grocery goods sector. Now, I think you know that supermarkets and supermarket chains and so on, aware of the government's intention in that regard, I think that the message should be very clear to them in relation to their pricing policy, and I would expect that they would act accordingly.
Thank you. That completes leaders' questions for today.